Zach is back. It's the Zach Gelb Show on Fox Sports 920 The Jersey.
All right, welcome back in. 416 from the Princeton Orthopedic Associates Studios. This is the Zach Gelb Show, Fox Sports 920 The Jersey. We'll get back to the Phil Jackson conversation a little bit on later in the show, but now let's go out to the hotline and welcome in a member of the New York Football Giants trying to make the big club this year, and that's Matt LaCosse, a tight end who's kind enough to join us right now. Matt, Zach Gelb, appreciate a few minutes. Thanks for the time, and how are you?
Hey, 1 second, train just went by. Sorry about that.
No worries. Where are you going?
I'm actually headed into the city today. My roommate from college came to visit, so we're going to go check out a few things.
Nice. So this has been a process that you've been in right now where you had the OTAs and you were a big-time star in the OTAs from everything we were reading, and now you're waiting for training camp. So what have you been up to leading up to the start of training camp these days?
I've just been out here training. I've been training at Test Sports Club in Martinsville, New Jersey, and it's been great so far. Just trying to stay in the best physical shape possible for the upcoming season and give myself the best opportunity to make the squad.
Tell me a little bit more about Test Football Academy, because we've had some of those trainers on before. Tell me how they're trying to get you in shape and all ready to go to try to make this 53-man roster for the Giants.
Well, yeah, Geir Gudmundsen and Kevin Dunn do a great job with all of us. It's very individualized. They cater to our specific needs. I've been able to sit down and talk with both of them about exactly what I need and what I need to do to stay healthy and get better. And it's been great. It's a huge facility, a huge turf field that helps with a lot of movement training. Everything about it has been great. They've been very helpful for me in my career and hopefully making it a very long and prosperous career.
We were talking to Geir right before the NFL draft and also during the combine period, and he talked about how much it's important, the mental element of the game of football, and to try to get away from football a little bit because we know how much dedicated you guys are to your craft. So I know you're going in the city today. You're going to have some fun. What are some other things that you do for fun in the off season when you get a little break from training?
I love going out fishing. I've been trying to find a good place to fish around New Jersey. So if you have any places for me, let me know. but I like to go. I'm from Chicago, so I go back and I go fishing around there. Just hanging out with my buddies. I'm a real big family guy, and me and my friends are all really close. So just anything to do with them, I'm willing to do. Just if it's just hang out in the backyard, barbecuing, just chilling, that's the perfect night for me.
I'm not a big fisherman, but I will say I was on a boat actually a few weekends ago, and I thought I finally got something and ended up being a stingray, and it absolutely sucked, Matt.
Oh, yeah, that's no good right there.
No doubt about it. Matt LaCosse with us right now on the Zach Gelb Show. So you've been trying to make the Giants for the last 2 years. You had the injuries with the hamstring and the knee problems. You had a very impressive OTAs. Just give me a little bit, what about these last 2 years, what they've been like, and also how you're feeling from a health standpoint?
Well, my rookie year was a little bit of a whirlwind. I know the train's about to pass. But the rookie year was a whirlwind. Got hurt pretty quickly, came back, was on their practice squad, then got to play the last two games of the season, got to play on primetime football, which was pretty cool. And then last year had a good OTA and a good camp, and just got hurt during preseason. And was on IR all year, and then came back and had a very good OTAs this season. So I'm just trying to look to build off of that and stay healthy, of course, the biggest thing in my mind right now, and then just get better and help the team win.
Ultimately, your play in training camp and also the preseason will dictate if you're going to make this 53-man roster and be a part of the New York Giants organization. But you talked a little bit about the success that you had in OTAs. Just what do you think that you did prove to the Giants coaching staff in OTAs, and what are some things you think you still need to improve on with your game?
I don't think I proved anything to anyone. I think I reiterated some stuff pretty well. I think I high point the ball very well. I know my assignments very well. I'm a serviceable blocker, but I think I just need to continue to make those plays in camp and everything along those lines, and I think I'll be fine.
How about the competition at your position? Because you have Ellison they just brought in. They drafted Evan Engram. Will Ty's coming back. So how about that competition with the group of guys that you're getting to know here at the tight end spot for the Giants?
Yeah, it's a stiff competition. All those guys are very, very good players, very talented. But that's what makes my job fun, too. It's just a good group of guys. They're all amazing people. And it's just been fun so far. So just looking forward to getting out, playing, and working hard. And what happens, happens.
What stands out to you specifically with Evan Engram? Because there's a lot of noise with him being a first-round pick in the Giants organization. So how about a little bit more on Evan Engram and your relationship with him so far?
The big thing that sticks out for me with him is his willingness and ability to block. I think people are giving him a bad rap for it. And I think that's one of the things that he actually does very, very well, at least so far in OTAs. He's shown it extremely well. Of course, he's an explosive playmaker and extremely fast and talented. He's also a phenomenal person, too. But, yeah, I think his ability and willingness to block really stood out for me so far.
And that's a big thing because you're right. A lot of people think he's just one of those guys that will play in the slot and he's not an excellent blocker. So that's encouraging to hear as we're talking to Matt LaCosse, who's trying to make the Giants this upcoming season. Your run and pass blocking abilities, because we know the Giants' offensive line isn't a strength and a tight end can help enhance that. Just how about your run blocking and pass blocking abilities?
Yeah, I think I'm a very serviceable run blocker and pass blocker. There's one thing I'm going to give you. I'm going to give you effort towards it. I think that's 90% of it is just the willingness and the want to block somebody. And it works both ways. The better you block, the more passes you get to catch. So I enjoy it. I enjoy the challenge. And I know everybody in that room also enjoys the challenge. So it's going to be a fun training camp and preseason.
Growing up as a kid, who were some of your favorite football players? Who were some of those role models in football that you really looked up to?
You know what? I didn't really have a chance to watch him play at all. I've only seen highlights. But my father and my mother are huge Walter Payton fans. I'm from Chicago. So just growing up and hearing stories about him and how he lived his life and the role model he was off the field just really was someone I looked up to. And, of course, I played linebacker when I was a kid, so I loved Brian Urlacher.
And just how about about now, when you look inside this Giants locker room, they have a lot of veterans. They have Eli Manning, who's won two Super Bowls. Who are some of the guys that really just took you under their wing so far in your young career in the Giants locker room?
I mean, Eli's been huge with me. Me and him have a pretty good relationship. We understand each other very well, and I understand what he's looking for on the field and what type of routes he wants and what type of plays and coverages he's looking at. So I think me and him have a very good relationship. I think Rhett Ellison, our new addition at tight end, he's had more experience than me, so he's definitely helped me blocking standpoint and just little tidbits here and there. But everyone's been very helpful since my rookie year in the Giants, and I couldn't be happier with an organization.
When you look at this offense, we know the offensive line is going to be the key, but in the offseason they bring in Brandon Marshall. Odell Beckham is still there and is the biggest part of that offense. Just how about this offense and the potential with the excitement that this offense could be after having a rough year last year?
Yeah, it has some potential to be explosive. Brandon Marshall is a big target. He's unbelievable athletic specimen. Odell, of course, everyone knows how explosive and phenomenal he is and can be. Sterling Shepard, I think, is going to have a huge breakout year this year. He had a great offseason. Very smart, intelligent person. And I think our offensive line has definitely improved. I think they're a lot better, and I think it's going to be – I think the sky's the limit for this offense this season.
What do you have to do to make the team, in your opinion?
I just have to keep showing that I can make plays and be on cue with the quarterbacks and block well and stay healthy. Stay healthy is the number one thing with me. If I can stay healthy and compete for a job, I think my chances are pretty good.
How much do you still think about the past with the injuries? Is it tough to try to move forward just knowing what has happened in the past in your career?
Yeah, anyone will tell you it's easy to not think about. Like, they don't think about the past, but it creeps into your head a little bit. But you just, during the off season, you just do the best you can with your sleep, how you eat, how you train, and you give yourself the best opportunity to go in and stay healthy and compete for a job.
And finally, before we let Matt LaCosse run, I actually went to college with Colin Thompson, the tight end out of Temple, is also trying to make the team. Any good stories with Colin as of late?
Colin Thompson, he wears these shoes. they have to weigh 5 pounds each. They are the biggest cleats I've ever seen in my life. And I give him crap about it all the time, but he definitely needs to up his cleat game. If someone out there can help him, get in contact with him, get him some different cleats. I hope he's listening because he needs to hear it too. but yeah, if we could help Colin Thompson with his cleat game, it would be great.
You got it. Where are you going for dinner tonight in the city?
Yeah, I think we're just going to grab I've been telling him about – I'm from Chicago, so I'm a big pizza guy, and he's from Chicago too. So I think we're just going to have a – we're going to find a pizza spot.
Well, New York, New York pizza is better than Chicago pizza. You know that, right?
That's a debate that I could have for hours.
I may be going to Chicago, actually, for Labor Day. What's the one pizza place in Chicago that I have to go to?
Lou Malnati's.
Okay.
Lou Malnati's. Oh.
And what's the play there?
Just go deep dish cheese pizza.
You got it. Well, I'll hold you to it. Best of luck. Matt LaCosse joining us right now on the Zach Gelb Show, Test Football Academy as well. Matt, we appreciate a few minutes. Thanks so much.
Oh, thank you.